Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to go ahead and review the Bravo Concealment RTT Kydex Holster Outdoor Waistband. I'll go ahead and put a link in the description. I chose the black colored model. They actually have three different colors: black, FTE Flat Dark Earth, and also Coyote Brown. These are actually retailing on their website for $69.99. Obviously, you have to include shipping as well. The turnaround time on their website is saying somewhere between 6 to 8 weeks. Obviously, they make these on the spot. They don't have a huge warehouse, and of course, these are made here in the USA. They make them for several different pistols, such as the 1911s, Glocks, obviously, Smith & Wesson M&Ps, Ruger HK, etc., etc. Go ahead and check out their website. The Kydex is actually made from a pretty good thickness, which is 0.08 inches, which is, I think, pretty common. They do have some which are a little bit more thinner, but I think those will probably break under stress or if you fall on it. So the 0.08 is actually pretty standard now compared to a lot of other different companies out there in the market. Now, this is the RTT holster, which is basically a trimmed, quote-unquote, trimmed-down version of their standard Kydex out the waistband holster, which is called their Patriot holster. Now, you can also get these with the light as well if you want to. Again, check out the website. I believe you can get some for the Surefire lights for the pistols, and of course you can get one without it. You can also have belt loops or J-hooks. The one that I ordered, I just got the belt loops on mine just to feel a little bit more secure. You can also get them with J-hooks, so you can actually take them out of take them off of the position of the pants or switch them around if you wanted to as well. The quality is actually very solidly made. It doesn't feel like it's going to break or bend. There's a lot of different holes here where you can actually position your belt loops or J-hooks on your belt. So if you want to have a higher ride on the holster with the belt, you can do that as well. Or if you want to have it a little bit lower, you can do that also. It's pretty simple. Just use a Phillips screwdriver, unscrew these, and you can position them however you want to. The retention on this is actually pretty good as well. And before I continue, the standard holster here, it doesn't actually have this little Velcro patch right here. I actually added that myself, super glue, and also the extra adhesive on the back. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take a look at how it retains. Let's do a safety check. Nothing in the magwell, nothing in the chamber here. Checked it as well before. So let's go ahead and insert this. The retention again is actually pretty good, where it actually locks into the trigger guard. As you can probably see, it's kind of hard to get it to fall out unless you use excessive force or use a lot of weight on it. But it retains pretty good. The draw is actually pretty smooth as well. You can also hear the click when the gun goes into the trigger guard, so you know that you're getting a solid lock on there. There's also a little groove here, a little angled area where you can, whenever you do draw, you can have your three fingers on the bottom to grab in there smoothly near the body and obviously draw, which is a really nice feature. You don't get to see a lot of this handcrafted work from a lot of different holsters. Also on the sides, I'm not sure if you can see, I'll see if I can zoom in. The edges are actually done pretty good as well. Let's see if I can zoom in on that. As you can see, it's nice and shiny, so you're not going to be rubbing against your clothing or tearing your clothes apart. They did a pretty good job on that. Again, my initial thoughts is that it is a very well made holster. Highly recommend it. Now they do also have in the waistband as well, but I actually have one from Galco. This is the one that I actually typically use for out the waistband. You can also use it as a range holster if you'd like as well. But again, go ahead and check out the website. They have a lot of options out there. And I believe also the Patriot holster, they have one where you can actually have it at a 10 degree cant instead of a straight up 90 degree. I personally prefer the 90 degree, so there's less errors in the draw. But again, that's personal preference for everyone. Yeah, and the holster, you know, again, it's made solid. It's molded perfectly to the gun itself. Now the sweat guard is not the greatest. It doesn't actually go all the way up to the back of the slide here, but again, you probably don't really need that depending on how high you're going to be riding. Probably goes up to, let's say, about an inch and a half below the back of the slide rail. Alright guys, that's pretty much it. If you guys got any questions, leave your comments in the section below, and I'll see if I can answer them. Thanks for watching.